This is Falcon Edufin and I'm Jan. In today's session, we'll see the concept of contango and backwardation in the futures market. I'll explain the concept of backwardation and contango with the help of an example. So let's start with contango. Imagine you are a trader who trades in gold and I am a jewelry maker who consumes gold for making jewelry and I sell those jewelry in the market. So I'm coming to you and approaching you and I ask you, what is the price for an ounce of gold? So you tell me an ounce of gold costs $1,200. So you're going to tell me I'll charge you $1,200 per ounce of gold if you want to purchase it today. So what I tell you is, hang on, I don't want gold today because I already have some gold left with me which my jewelers are working with and they are making jewelry with the gold that is already available, and I want your gold only 3 months down the line. I don't want your gold right away. So I'm asking you, what will be the price that you will charge 3 months afterwards to deliver gold? So you tell me, see, I'm not going to charge you the same $1,200 if you want the gold 3 months down the line, because I'll be incurring various cost to keep the gold with me. So I'll be incurring the cost of storage. So if I have to keep the gold with me for 3 months, I have to store it in a proper place, safe place where it cannot be stolen. So I'll be incurring the cost of storage. And apart from that, since gold being a very precious commodity, I'll have to insure that because I don't know if I'll be safe from theft or any other calamities. So I'll have to incur the cost of insurance for it. And apart from that, what happens is, if I sell you the gold today, I'll be getting this $1,200 and I can go and invest this $1,200 in a bank and I can earn some interest on it. So if I'm going to sell you this gold after 3 months, I'll have to forego on that interest income. So there is an opportunity cost for me on the interest income. Opportunity cost for interest foregone. So you're telling me, see, if you want gold 3 months down the line, I cannot sell it to you at $1,200 per ounce, but I can sell it to you at $1,250 per ounce. Okay? So you tell me, if you want the gold today and if you're going to give me cash today and buy the gold, I'm going to sell it to you at $1,200 per ounce. And if you want gold 3 months down the line, this is today, this is 3 months. So all this conversation is happening today between you and me. 3 months down the line, if you want gold, I can sell it to you at $1,250 per ounce. So you are asking, again, I'll ask you, it's okay, 3 months down the line, I'll purchase this gold and I would also like to, you know, purchase the gold from you further 6 months down the line as well. So after 6 months, what will be the price in which you can give me gold? So you're telling me, if I have to save gold for you for 6 months, I'll be incurring additional storage cost, additional insurance cost, and additional cost of interest that I will forego. That is the interest income that I will forego. So I'll have to charge a little extra for that. So I'll charge $1,300 per ounce of gold. Does this seem fair to you all? Because when I'm buying it today, I'm going to give you cash today and I'll buy it at $1,200. If I'm not going to buy it from you today, you'll have to store it, you'll have to insure it, you'll have to forego the interest income. So you are incurring so many costs just because you have agreed to sell it to me 3 months down the line. So you will have to charge little more from me for keeping it for that time. So this is a fair thing. So this is how a normal market works. And this situation is called as a contango situation. So a contango situation is a situation where the futures price today, that is F naught, futures price today. I'm putting zero because I'm trying to represent the futures price today is greater than the spot price today for the commodity. So spot price is nothing but my $1,200, and 3 months future price is nothing but my $1,250, and 6 months price is nothing but my $1,300. So what is a contango? A contango is a situation where the current futures price for a commodity is greater than the current spot price for a commodity. So let's try to plot it in a graph. So I have a graph here where in the x-axis I am giving time or maturity of futures, and here I'll have price, and all this is today. So this is 1200, 1250, 1300, 1350, and so on. And here it is today it is here, and this is 3 months down the line, and this is 6 months down the line, and this is 9 months down the line, this is 1 year down the line. So today the gold is, if I have to purchase gold from you today, I'll pay $1,200, and if I have to purchase gold from you in 3 months time, I'll pay you $1,250, and if I have to purchase gold from you in 6 months time, I'll have to pay you $1,300, and similarly it just keeps increasing. So how does my futures curve look? It's an upward sloping curve. So this is my spot price, that is the price at time zero, and today my 3 months futures will be at $1,250, and my 6 months futures will be $1,300, and my 9 months futures will be $1,350, so on and so forth. So this is how an upward sloping futures curve, this is called as upward sloping futures curve. And this situation is nothing but a contango situation, where the futures price for a commodity today is more than the current spot price in the cash market. So now what is a backwardation? Backwardation is exactly opposite of contango. So let me again explain backwardation with an example. Imagine you are a wheat manufacturer and I am a industrialist who manufactures bread. And what happens is suddenly the weather is so bad, and the weather gets very bad that, you know, the wheat production gets very hit. It's raining so heavily that you're not able to grow wheat. So there is a sudden shortage of wheat in the market. But for me, since I'm a bread manufacturer and I have to keep manufacturing bread throughout the year, currently I need wheat as my raw material to get my production going, to get my bread manufacture going. I don't want to stop my bread production just because there is no wheat available in the market. So what happens is there is a sudden supply crunch. So what I would be ready to do is, okay, I'm okay paying a little more value for buying the commodity today than buying it 3 months down the line. I know 3 months down the line the weather is not going to be the same, and it's going to ease out a bit, and the production of wheat is going to improve, and the supply of wheat is going to increase, and I'll be getting uninterrupted supply of wheat in the future. So what I would do is, I would not mind spending a little more extra amount and buy the wheat today, so that I don't get my production impaired, than, you know, waiting and getting the commodity sometime in the future. So what happens is, in such kind of situations, the spot price for a commodity, say for example, the wheat generally trades at say 100 per barrel, sorry, 100 per metric ton, if I'm $100 per MT, Okay, so when I'm purchasing in a normal market, I'm going to purchase at 100 per metric ton, the wheat. Okay, so what happens is right now there is a crisis situation. The supply is very short. Supply is very short. Very restricted, very limited. So I want this wheat and I don't want my production to get hampered because of this short supply. So what I'm ready to pay is, you know what, I can pay even $150 per MT to make sure that I have the enough raw material for my production. But I know, you know, 3 months down the line, this situation is going to improve and I don't have to pay this much for wheat. And I can pay, I mean, I can enter into a future contract at $130 per MT. So what happens in this case is, say if I'm going to plot this in a graph, I have an x-axis and I have a y-axis. Similarly, this is the price and all this happens today again. So today in this current situation, I'm having a crisis. So I'm ready to pay $150 for wheat. But in the future, 3 months, 6 months, 9 months and a year down the line, I know the situation is going to improve. And say 9 months down the line, it's going to be a peak season for wheat and I can get wheat even at $110 per MT. So what happens is 150, 140, 130, 120, $110. So this is $130. This is 3 months, 6 months, 9 months, 1 year. So this is time and here comes our price. So right now the spot price for this particular commodity is at 150. But today, if I have to enter into a futures contract, I know that the situations will become better and I'll be able to get the commodity at a cheaper price. So I would be paying less for the futures when I have to enter into this particular commodity future than when I purchase it in the spot market currently. So this kind of situation is nothing but a backwardation situation. It is an inverted forward curve. So this is a downward sloping forward curve or futures curve. So this is nothing but a situation where the spot price for a commodity today is greater than the forward price or the futures price for the commodity today. So contango is a situation where the situation where the future price is more than the spot price, that is you have an upward sloping futures curve, and backwardation is a situation where the spot price is greater than the forward price and you have a downward sloping futures curve. I hope you understood the context of contango and backwardation. In our next video, we'll see what is a normal contango and normal backwardation. Thank you.